the debate tonight. Congress party plays a cruel joke on farmers. Madhya Pradesh farmers, who were hopeful of getting a loan waiver after the new government came in, were left disappointed. Farmers received 25 rupees to 300 rupees as loan waiver instead of the promised 2 lakh rupees.
अच्छा कितना कर्ज था आपके ऊपर?
1,25,000.
तो जो लिस्ट में अभी माफी वाली आई उसमें कितना है?
249.
कितने?
249.
आपके ऊपर कैसीसी और वो कर्ज कितना था?
2,55,000.
ठीक है, और जो अभी माफी करी है सरकार ने उसमें लिस्ट में आपका कितना माफ हुआ?
The agriculture minister of the state has called this cruel joke a human error.
जहाँ तक खरगोन और राजगढ़ की बात है, वो ह्यूमन एरर है, वो हमारी संज्ञान में आया है और हमने उस पर जो है उस पर हमने निर्देश दिए हैं और उसके ऊपर कार्रवाई चालू हो गई.
The newly elected Congress government that largely came to power in Madhya Pradesh with their pro-agriculture promises were left red-faced. Numerous farmers who didn't even apply for the loan waiver were enlisted as beneficiaries.
Somebody has taken loan, but their name has not been included in the list, and somebody has not taken even a penny as a loan, but their name has been enlisted.
With waivers of just a few hundred rupees and dubious applicants getting benefits, Mirror Now asks, was Congress's farm loan waiver promise just a jumla? Let's debate.
Well, I must point out to our audience that farmers in Madhya Pradesh have committed suicide even after this farm loan waiver was announced. And now that the actual waiver is being executed, we see that farmers are getting 25 rupees, 30 rupees, 300 rupees instead of the 2 lakh that was promised by the state. Other questions that the state government in Madhya Pradesh has not answered: where will the money come from? And how will you pay for it given the heavy debt that the state is already under? Joining me on the show, Richard George, spokesperson of the Congress party. Anupam is the chief spokesperson of Swaraj India representing farmers. Gulresh Sheikh, spokesperson of the BJP. Sudhir Tiwari is a farmer leader from Madhya Pradesh. Yogesh Pandey from the Swabhimani Shetkari Sangathan. And Akash Jindal, senior economist, will join us through the course of the conversation. I want to start with those who represent the farmers to find out how bad the problem really is. सुधीर तिवारी जी, अगर मेरी आवाज़ आप तक आ रही है, क्या आप हमें समझा सकते हैं कि अभी जो दिक्कतें हो रही हैं ये ऋण माफ़ी से, कितने किसानों के साथ प्रॉब्लम्स हुई है और क्या आपने किसी से बात की, ये क्यों हो रहा है?
देखिए, जो जय किसान ऋण माफ़ी योजना है, इस योजना में थोड़ी सी उसमें ने जो है पेचीदगियाँ कर रखी हैं. वो इस तरीके से कर रखी हैं कि इन्होंने तीन टाइप के फॉर्म दिए गए हैं किसानों को, कि एक वाइट कलर का फॉर्म है, सफ़ेद कलर का फॉर्म है, एक पिंक कलर का है, रेड कलर का फॉर्म है, और एक है ग्रीन कलर का फॉर्म, हरे कलर का. और इन सब फॉर्म में इनको जो है, अगर किसी का आधार कार्ड, आधार जो है, आधार नंबर अगर बैंकों में लिंक नहीं है, तो उसको सफ़ेद फॉर्म भरना है, पहले बैंक से लिंक करवाना है. मतलब पहले कुल मिला के थोड़ी सी पेचीदगियाँ ऐसी हैं, इसी कारण किसान जो हैं उनको ये डिले हो रहा है, उनका जो लोन का जो वेवर का जो वो है वो डिले हो जा रहा है. साथ साथ इसमें एक और चीज़ है, मुझे अभी बहुत सारे मेरे किसान भाइयों से मुझे बात करके मैंने उनको पता चला कि अभी उनको बैंकों की तरफ से कोई आश्वासन नहीं मिला है. भले ही सरकार उसको बोल रही है कि हम लोग लोन माफ़ करेंगे 2 लाख रुपये तक, परंतु बैंकों की तरफ से कोई एश्योरेंस नहीं हुआ है. साथ साथ ये जितना भी लोन जो अभी शुरुआत में पहले उसमें वो माफ़ करने का चल रहा है, वो उनकी जो सहकारी मंडी जो है, बैंक जो सरकारी समितियां हैं, सरकारी समितियों से जो उन्होंने लोन लिया रहता है, इसमें अधिकतर किसानों का एक लाख रुपये से सबका नीचे ही होगा किसी भी किसान का. क्योंकि इसमें जो मंडी जो समितियों से क्या होता है कि जो किसान है अपनी जो फसल है समितियों में ही बेचता है, तो उसके अधिकतर अभी जो जैसे अभी धान की फसल हुई, तो धान की फसल समितियों ने खरीद ली, तो उनका जो लोन था पहले का, उसका जो उन्होंने जब धान बेची है तो उसमें वो सेट हो गया, एडजस्ट हो गया है. तो अधिकतर जो किसानों का बहुत कम लोन ही है, अगर ये जो है समितियों के माध्यम से जैसा वो कह रहे हैं, सबसे पहले उनका कहना है, जो सरकार का कहना है और हमारे किसान भाइयों की तरफ से हमें जो बात आई है सामने, कि सबसे पहले जो लोन को वेव ऑफ करेंगे, ऋण माफ करेंगे, वो समितियों का करेंगे सबसे पहले, उसके बाद बैंकों की बात बात आएगी। बट ये इसमें किसान बड़े पशुपेश में है, किसान समाज बड़ा पशुपेश में है, किसानों में बड़ा रोष है कि क्या ये होगा या नहीं होगा, अभी भी वो लोग क्लियर वो नहीं है। और ये जो है इसमें अधिकतर जो है सरकारी बैंकों से लोन भी कम है, मगर प्राइवेट बैंकों से सभी बहुत से किसानों ने ज़्यादा लोन लिया है, परंतु प्राइवेट बैंकों का शुरू से ही माननीय कमलनाथ जी ने पहले ही बोल रखा है कि सरकारी बैंकों का ही लोन होगा माफ़, बाकी प्राइवेट बैंकों से जिन्होंने लोन लिया वो माफ़ नहीं होगा। तो ऐसे में करीब करीब 30-40% जो किसान अलग हो जाते हैं वैसे ही इस जी।
इनफैक्ट अभी ask Anupam as well of Swaraj India. Anupam, have you been in touch at the Swaraj India with farmers in Madhya Pradesh? And we want to remind our viewers that Madhya Pradesh is the state where the farmers clashed with the police a couple of years ago. So it is it already had a severe problem as far as farmers were concerned. What is the status of this farm loan waiver right now, Anupam?
Yeah, Faye. Sudhirji has very well stated the ground, the problems being faced by farmers with respect to the loan waivers, with respect to the ground implementation of loan waiver scheme. Mm. But one thing which is true and very unfortunate, when we in general about governance and in particular about addressing the agrarian distress, the BJP or the Congress have a very similar model of operation when it comes to in general. When it comes to governance, yes, in general and addressing the agrarian distress in particular, the time when announcements are made, you have seen, Faye, these loan waiver announcements are generally made in a very sensational style.
Yes.
Chief ministers announce within days of assuming power, they try to make headlines by showing that within hours of swearing in, the loans of farmers have been waived off. When the announcements are made, generally the announcements are time-bound, unconditional. But later on, whether it is Madhya Pradesh, we are talking in a specific context of Madhya Pradesh, but when you go back and see what happened in Uttar Pradesh, what happened in Maharashtra, what happened in Karnataka, or what happened in Punjab, in all other states, there has been a similar pattern. Sensational style of making loan waiver announcements,
yes,
and later on we come to find that paltry sums are being waived off in the name of loan waiver and things like that. So in general, I have one thing to say, which is that when it comes to addressing the concerns of India's agriculture sector or the farmers, there is no political will either with the BJP or with the Congress. We have seen it very clearly.
Yes, yes.
One of the reasons why farmers are in agenda at this point of time is that there has been a farmers' movement, the farmers united against the yes. establishment, and they were the ones, the farmers who went on roads and they ensured that farmers get into the central of political agenda and narrative. But in real terms,
fact,
there
yes,
is no seriousness,
there's no seriousness,
political will to really
all right, Anupam, let's bring in the representatives of these two parties. Richard George represents the Congress in Madhya Pradesh, joining us from Bhopal. Richard George, here's my question to you. Was the entire promise of a farm loan waiver a election gimmick that the Congress government in Madhya Pradesh had no intention to fulfill? What are the errors that are being made right now? And to dismiss this as human errors, if they were human errors, why would there be so many problems with it? Why would there be so many across the state of Madhya Pradesh?
Well, to let you know, first of all, that the government is absolutely serious, and the prime focus of the state and the chief minister, obviously, is solving the agriculture sector and reviving the agriculture sector.
Okay.
Loan waiver promise was definitely not a joke or a jumla. It was announced even before the elections, and we kept the promise.
Kamalnathji,
after assuming the office, the first file that he signed was on the loan waiver. The first file after assuming the office he signed was on the loan waiver, and the first action that was being taken, and when all the governing bodies came together, The first action was derived at solving the farmer's plight over here and also keeping the promise which we had given of loan waivers for the farmers. Now the process has already begun into it, and you can see there has been action also been taken. The very first thing that I would say is, to achieve any goal, there has to be a very pure intention which has already been displayed by the government over here and displayed by Kamal Nathji. 15th Feb is when we rolled out the forms of which my friend was talking about. There were three categories that were being made and made it simple and easy so that there is no confusion. Also to eliminate any irregularities and also to ensure if there is any genuine beneficiary into it, he shouldn't or he or she shouldn't be
okay,
left
so tell
out
me
office,
something. Tell me something. One second. Richard George. When Uttar Pradesh made similar mistakes with their farm loan waiver, at that point, the Congress representatives, Priyanka Chaturvedi, said, Yogi Adityanath's government, cruel joke on UP farmers, 9% is a generous loan waiver that the Prime Minister has promised, and this is what they're getting, 10 rupees and 37 rupees. So when the mistake was made by the BJP in Uttar Pradesh, the Congress jumped on it very quickly and called this a cruel joke. How is this not a cruel joke from you? I want to understand, since you're saying that you're committed to solve the problems of farmers, you said revive the farm sector. Where is this money going to come from? We understand that this is going to cost between 35,000 crore rupees and 38,000 crore rupees. Where is the money going to come from? Does Mr. Kamal Nath have a budget in front of him to tell us where this money is going to come from?
Now, first of all, to you know, talk about how this is going to happen, and when you talked about like there have been amount like 25 rupees or 30 rupees that have been given and been termed as loan waiver, let me tell you that is not something which which is as a part of a loan waiver. Mm-hmm. Why? Because let me tell you, 15th Jan, the forms were distributed and the farmers have been instructed that the time and the date to be for the farmers to submit these forms filled is 5th of February. Now, in the 5th of February, when the farmers would fill the details and when they will give it up to you, the government will then and the official body would then work on those data. They would ensure that everyone is being answered, everyone is being attended, there is no irregularities. And then they have also committed that they would start giving the certificates from the 22nd of February. Now, if the process is still on way and it has not been completed yet, I don't understand why these amounts are being termed as a loan waiver. I definitely condemn this particular, whatever statement has been done by anybody, it is not towards the farm loan waiver. And secondly,
so this list, one second, Richard George, one second. The list that has been put out by the government of Madhya Pradesh that lists out the name, the Aadhaar number, the address and the PIN code and the outstanding amount. This has nothing to do with farm loan waivers because from what I understand, this is what has happened. These are the kind of errors, irregularities in the amount of loan, irregularities in the names. Farmers who were dead are showing up on the list as beneficiaries. Farmers who had taken 20,000 rupees 3 years ago are now showing an outstanding debt of 1.89 lakh. Farmers who'd repaid their debts and don't have outstanding payment to any bank have figured on the list as beneficiaries. Farmers who have not taken any loan have found their names on the list. And of course, farmers who are owed a waiver are not on the list at all. But you haven't answered my question of where is the money going to come from. Let me tell you what the budget looks like. Madhya Pradesh's budget as of 2018 is 1,86,685 crore rupees. Madhya Pradesh's debt as of 2018 is 1,87,637 crore rupees. You are in more debt than your entire state budget. Where is the money going to come from?
Well, our Chief Minister Kamal Nathji has already promised and has committed. Now, I'll tell you that the entire scheme focused is, we are going to cover 55 lakh farmers in the entire state. And the budget that has been sanctioned for this scheme is around 55,000 crores.
But initially,
and the supplementary budget also has been provided, and initially 5 crores
from
has already
where?
Been provided for this.
No, one second. Mr. Richard George, you must understand that we do careful research here, and we understand how money works. If you don't have it, you can't spend it. That is the universal rule of money. So either you're going to take away from something else, like education or infrastructure or some other kind of project that you're working on. But to say that you have allotted 55,000 crore rupees that you don't have, I don't understand how that is going to work, but I'm going to open this up to the rest of my panelists right now. Akash Jindal joins us. He's a senior economist. Akash Jindal, the Congress party in Madhya Pradesh promised a farm loan waiver. They've delivered something like 25 rupees to some farmers, 300 to some others. Several farmers left off the list. And more importantly, we don't know where the money is going to come from. Akash Jindal. I'm not sure if Akash Jindal can hear me. Gurdesh Sheikh of the BJP. It seems like both the BJP and the Congress have completely run out of ideas when it comes to helping our farmers, Gurdesh Sheikh.
I'm getting echo.
All right, we'll get that fixed as well.
What the Minister of Agriculture told is totally rubbish.
Go ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can. Go ahead.
Yeah, what the Minister of Agriculture, Mr. Yadav, said that it was a human error is completely rubbish. Human error can take place in one or two places, but this thing has happened in more than 17 districts of Madhya Pradesh. And Faye, this was bound to happen. We were telling this from the day one that these people are telling big bunch of lies. And it is not exaggeration if I say that Congress party in Madhya Pradesh has committed the biggest loot, political loot of farmers' votes. And they have just not looted the farmers' votes, but whatever we have given them, like we have given them Bhavantar Yojana, they also want to snatch it away from them. If they want to waiver the loans of the farmers, it could have been done like we have waived all the dues of electricity of poor people who were living below poverty line, and it was waived within the span of 7 days. So if you have intention, you can do it, but it was totally an electoral promise and a fake promise based on which they formed the government. And there is one more catch, Faye, which nobody is mentioning. They have put one more claw, and that claw is that whoever has repaid the loan up till 31st of March 2018, and they have taken the loan again, their loans won't be wavered off. So that means they will be wavering off the loans of the defaulters only. And I can say you that our farmers are not defaulters, but these imposters are defaulters. They are willful defaulters.
So hang on. Gulresh Sheikh, it's very easy to filibuster when it's very easy to make these statements when you're in opposition. But remember that you run the state of Uttar Pradesh, where similar promises were made by the government of BJP run by Yogi Adityanath. Similar mistakes were made in the farm loan waiver. So actually the question we should be asking at this point is, what is the difference really between the Congress and the BJP? Other than the fact that you make these large promises when you come into power before the elections and then don't keep the promises, please tell me one difference between these two parties. I'm going to go back to my farmer leaders, Yogesh Pandey. If you've had a chance, and I know that the Setkari Sangathan also has members in Madhya Pradesh, what are they telling you about the state of affairs there?
No, the state of affairs is really sad. Rightly, Anupam has said, the both parties, BJP and the Congress, are at an equal footing. What happened in Karnataka? Hardly 500 crores are waived and the list are not in the public domain. Take it Maharashtra. Maharashtra government also declared farm loan waiver. It's a 2 years and still no one knows what is the exactly figure, how much people are waived. In Madhya Pradesh, there are total 82 lakh farm loan, crop loan accounts, and total outstanding debt is 62,000 crore. Now, where the money is going to come? Similar thing happened in the insurance scheme. So, what are at BJP and what may be Congress? The word of farm loan waiver is a very lucrative word, and it is just illusion. It's a tall promise made prior to the polls, and once they are elected, then the things are before us. So, this is making a mockery of the farmers, and now they will come with the excuses. The rightly minister was not able to answer from where money is going to come from, where they are going to fund. The state is in the debt of 180,000 crore, and in three states, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, and ticket Madhya Pradesh, total outstanding crop loan is 150,000 crore. So the promise made by Congress that they are going to waive off all this loan. So from where money is going to come? And the reality is the farmers are getting 5 rupees, 10 rupees. And it is premature. Let's give them time of 1 month. but then the reality will be out in the public domain, because it's not that easy. You throw the promises and don't fulfill it. For all are watching it very carefully, and they will have to pay, and they will have to bear the price in up, the price for the in upcoming elections, because you can't fool the farmers. Yafe.
Akash Jindal is back with us. I have a Hello. Quick question for Akash Jindal. Akash Jindal, we've had economist after economist tell Hello. Us that farm loan waivers are terrible for the economy, they're terrible for the farmers, they're terrible for the banks. Now it turns out that the Congress party that promised these waivers still doesn't know where the money is going to come from. There's been no answer about where this 35,000 crore rupees or 55,000 crore rupees is going to come from. The state is tremendously in debt, Akash Jindal. Go ahead.
Very right, Faye. In fact, this was the question which was in my mind. I have studied the GSDP of the state, the resources of the state, the expenditure of the state. And I, as an economist, with due regards and lot of respect for the Congress party, totally fail to understand where would the money come from. This was the question which I wanted to ask our Congress friend. Now, okay, you want to help the farmers. It's a good idea. Agri-rural distress is there. But according to my study of Indian agriculture, my organization Akash Jindal Dotton clearly says the best way to help the agriculture is to get him better yield, get him better storage, get him better price, get him better seeds, better get him better fertilizers, get him proper irrigation. All these things are required, because let me inform my friend from Congress. Now the issue with Indian agriculture is most of the cases, agriculture is not even viable, forget profitable. So I think you would have done a much better service had you tried your hand at making agriculture viable and then profitable. And as far as loan waivers are concerned, I'm with you that agriculturist brothers need to be helped, our annadata need to be helped. But earlier also, around 10 years ago, we had a huge agricultural loan waiver. Has it actually worked? Because the plight of our agriculturist brother is still very bad. So I think firstly, the concept of agricultural loan waivers, I need to understand from our Congress friend, how would it help? According to me, yes, we need to help our agriculturist brothers, but we need to make the agriculture viable and profitable. Secondly, now this huge sum, please explain me. I have all the data regarding your state. Where is this money going to come? How are your sources of income going to increase dramatically? Or is it some center allocation which you are seeking? So please explain me this thing.
Well, those are all fair questions. Richard George, do you have answers for any of those questions?
Yeah, absolutely. When we understand, yeah, when the BJP government had left us, the state was almost under 2 lakh crores debt. And even after that, pre-elections and post-elections, we've been sticking on to our commitment. And as Kamal Nath ji has already said, that this is going to be a prime focus and it is going to be a promise to be kept. From where the money is going to come, I suppose, yes, Kamal Nath ji has his own plans. And it is just like, you know, few days down the line with the government, he has given dates as well. He has given that from 22nd of February, we'll be starting distributing the certificates. So most of the answer, and especially the answer where my friends are asking, where will you bring the money from? That would also be answered very soon by Kamal Nath ji.
So tell me something. Richard George, what business... Richard George, what business did the Congress party have making a promise if you don't know where the money is going to come from? Isn't that fundamentally irresponsible? Agar aapke paas paise the hi nahi, to aapne aise promise kyun kiya?
I'm not saying we don't know where the money is going to come from. I'm not saying where the money is going to come from. What I'm saying is I'm showing the confidence in the person
Richard George, you said that the BJP left the state in 2 lakh crore rupees of debt, but you will still give away this money. So either the chief minister is a magician and he is going to create the money out of thin air, or you will have to adjust your budget for other heads. Now, which of the two is it? And why is it the Congress hasn't announced its plan yet?
No, definitely not a magician or something of that sort. But then we believe in what he has committed, and he definitely has the roadmap in his mind. As I said, 22nd February, we are going to be starting providing the certificates of loan waiver. And before that, definitely there's going to be answer, because a lot of people, especially the BJP, is wanting to know that where are you going to bring the money from? But yes, what I'm going to say is just wait for a while and wait for 22nd February when we begin the process of distributing the certificates. And before that, everything would be clear, as we committed and as we promised. Up to 2 lakh of loan would be waived for the farmers.
Well, Sudhir Tiwari, आपने अभी सुना कि कांग्रेस के रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ने क्या क्या कहा. उन्होंने कहा कि आप रुकिए, सब साफ साफ हो जाएगा. एक सेकंड. यस, वन सेकंड. सुधीर तिवारी.
व्हाट आई वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड.
नो, वन सेकंड मिस्टर जिंदल. लेट मी जस्ट गिव सुधीर तिवारी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू दिस एंड देन आई कम बैक टू यू. सुधीर जी, आप बोलिए.
मुझे जहां तक लग रहा है कि सब ये जो इसमें है ना, लैक ऑफ ट्रांसपेरेंसी है, उसमें क्लियरिटी नहीं है कि कैसे करेंगे. और ये मुझे लगता है किसी भी कमलनाथ जी के भी मन, अभी वो जो मुख्यमंत्री जी हैं, उनके पास भी अभी साफ सुथरा रोड मैप नहीं है कि वो कैसे करेंगे. बट चूंकि राहुल गांधी जी ने 10 दिन का बोल दिया था कि हम जो जैसे ही आते हैं और विद इन 10 डेज में हम लोग 2 लाख रुपए तक का लोन वेव करेंगे, उस चीज को ये जो है फॉर्म और पॉलिसी और प्रोसेस के थ्रू डिले हो रहा है. और ये डिले, चाहे मुझे लगता है कि शायद लोकसभा में चुनाव आने वाले हैं, लोकसभा के चुनाव आने वाले हैं, उसको मद्देनजर रखते हुए कि उनको बोला गया है कि आप डिले करिए, जिससे कि आने वाले चुनाव में उसका गलत रिवर्स इफेक्ट नहीं करे. बट मैं ये पूछना चाहता हूँ कि किसान का जीवन जो है, जो पैदा होता है तब से संघर्ष रहता है और जब मरता है तब तक संघर्ष करता है. और मुझे ये समझ में आता कि ये जो है फार्म कम्युनिटी को सीरियसली क्यों नहीं लेते हैं. फार्म कम्युनिटी के हाथ में योगी आदित्यनाथ जी ने भी जो लोन वेव की बात करी थी, जहां पंजाब की भी बात हुई है, वहां सभी जगह कहीं ना कहीं किसान को छला गया है, किसानों को चीट किया गया है. संविधान में ऐसा क्यों प्रायोजन वो होना नहीं चाहिए. हमें एक ऐसा रूल होना चाहिए कि साहब आप अगर कमिटमेंट करते हो अगर चुनाव से पहले, और अगर उसको फॉलो नहीं करते हो तो आपको डिस्क्वालीफाई होना चाहिए. आपको उस बात के लिए
ठीक. और योगेश पांडे,
आप किसान कम्युनिटी में काफी पारदर्शिता नहीं है अभी उनको बड़ा
फे आई वांट टू वन मेक वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सबमिशन. फे,
यस
फे, there are a lot of white elephants in the name of farmers. We saw, came across in the Maharashtra also, and there is no mechanism declared in the Madhya Pradesh. They just said blanketly that 2 lakh rupees loan waiver will be waived off. But what is the related ground? Because there are chances and there are the things in public domain. Today only I was reading, and lot of fake account, dummy accounts are there in last 3 terms of the BJP government, and there are chances, and that is the that lot of people have taken a dummy fake loans. So that has to be also ascertained. Just making the promises and giving the waiver, that will not serve the purpose. The okay. real needy farmers' loan should be waived off and he should be redressed. But that is not the case. So, yeah, that answer should be also answered by Mr. Minister.
I know that Akash Jindal had a point to make. Akash Jindal, go ahead, please, and then I'll take it back to the Congress.
Yeah, my first question to my Congress friend is, which is still unanswered. I have high respect for Congress party and its attempts to help farmers. But around 10 years ago, there was a huge farm loan waiver. Now, what I want to know is, what has been the impact, what has been the output result of that farm loan waiver? Can we say today that the plight of our agriculturalist brothers is better after that huge farm loan waiver, which happened around 10 years ago? Secondly, now, as you said, that Kamalnath Saab would be coming out how it has to be funded. I have respect for Kamalnath Saab, but wouldn't it have been a better idea, according to an economist and financial expert, according to my economics, it would have been a much better idea had first Kamalnath ji planned for the money and where the money has to come from. Then he would have allocated the funds, that this much amount I am going to allocate for loan waivers. Now, what I am able to make out here is that perhaps now loan waivers have been announced. Now you are saying that ultimately you have to sit together, you have to find out and locate where the money is going to come from. Shouldn't have it been a better financial planning that initially you should have known the sources, funds and the availability of funds, and accordingly you should have planned this loan waivers? And my first question regarding the outcome and the result of the earlier loan waivers, because as of now, our agriculture brothers are in a very, very bad situation. We know the situation of our agriculture brother. Agriculture is not even viable, forget profitable. And apart from this loan waivers, are you going to make any efforts to make agriculture viable and profitable? Because in case agriculture becomes profitable, my dear friend, perhaps in future, our agriculture brothers may not even need loans or forget loan waivers. So I think the target should be to make agriculture profitable. So how do you want to do that? How would that target be achieved?
Let me ask the question right now of the Congress representative, Richard George. Obviously, very valid questions asked by Akash Jindal as well. And I have a question for you. You did say that you will revive, that the Madhya Pradesh government has a plan to revive farming and the farm sector. What is that plan?
See, there are many things, and one thing that was vocally made very clear in day one, that it was even in the BJP era and the farmers' plight that were being brought out even during then, and when we had also seen about what has happened in the Bhavantar Yojana and why it was failing, is because the benefit that was being aimed to the farmer, the farmer did not get the benefit out of that Yojana. But some third party or a trader was, or a commission person was getting the benefit of that waiver. Seamlessly, there are so many other things where the governance can be improved, which Kamal Nath ji has already said that we are going to look into the arrangements and we are going to look into everything and eliminate irregularities and making the gap over there and making the sector more profitable with that. Also, you asked me one more question. Can you repeat that?
Well, that was going to be my follow-up question. Well, if your entire master plan of reviving the farm sector... One second, you should listen to the question. If your entire master plan of reviving the farm sector was, and I quote, bringing in the digital era, which I'll promise you the BJP has been doing or attempting to do for the last 5 years, farmers actually getting benefits of Yojanas and eliminating irregularities, then in that case, please tell us, like Akash Jindal asked us, what has been the benefit of the previous farm loan waiver the Congress party offered several elections ago? Have you managed to pull farmers out of poverty with that farm loan waiver? In the 10 years that you occupied the central government, did you manage to actually improve the cause of the farmers? Did you implement the Swaminathan committee report? If you'd have no plan in Madhya Pradesh, how are you different from the BJP?
No, absolutely. As I said, we have a plan, and which is why the entire execution of the farm loan waiver is being delivered step by step. As I said, 15th is where the forms were given. We are still waiting for the farmers to come up with the forms. 5th of February, when they come up with the form, with the forms, which is after that, the entire process is going to start. When we were talking about so many people, the duplication of records, there are so many people who are not farmers, but they've still been getting the benefit out of that. So these are the things that would be worked out once the forms are being submitted. And as I said, by 22nd of February, the certificates are going to start, the government is going to start providing the certificates. And before that,
just a quick question for Richard George. You do realize that there is a general election coming up in less than 3 months' time.
Kamal Nath ji has settled down.
You do realize that there is a general election coming up in less than 3 months' time, and people in Madhya Pradesh, including the farmers, will vote.
Yes.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure that you knew that.
Yes.
Let me now bring in the other, and I want to, Anupam, before I come to you, Gulresh Sheikh, Anupam, the solutions that are being offered by the Congress party are not different from what the BJP has been selling for the last 5 years, and none of it reflects the Swaminathan committee report. None of it reflects any of the research that has been done on agriculture. Look at the promises that the Congress made to the farmers before this election in Madhya Pradesh. Write-off farm loans, 50% subsidy on agriculture equipment, halving the power bills to farmers, subsidy of rupees 5 per litre of milk procurement, social security pension, rebate and registration fee of land documents, social security of 1,000 rupees per month to farmers after the age of 60, reinvestigation of the Mandsaur police firing incident, and regularization of daily wages. Now, incidentally, the Congress representative remembers none of these promises, and he so far told us, eliminate irregularities, bring farmers into the digital era, and make sure they get benefits of the Yojanas or the schemes that have been announced. All promises have been forgotten. Anubhav.
Right. Faye, look, at the core of addressing the ongoing agrarian distress, is making agriculture viable. One-time loan waiver is one aspect of that fact. If the Congress or the BJP at the center or at the state governments was really serious about addressing the agrarian crisis, the follow-up steps after the loan waiver would have been to ensure institutional measures for pricing and procurement. In the last 15 to 20 minutes, I've been hearing the Congress spokesperson, and I've also heard bits and pieces from the BJP. I haven't heard anything about ensuring institutional measures for pricing and procurement. And when we look back into the track record of the BJP government at center or at the track record of Congress during UPA 2 for that matter, none of them have been serious in implementing the Swaminathan Commission recommendation in the right spirit. There has been a lot of dodging, diversion, jumlebaji in the name of pricing, crop price. There has not been very serious efforts or attempts to ensure procurement in a right manner. We have all seen, even after MSPs are announced, which has not been at what the desirable level should have been, even at those MSPs, just 6% of the crops are being procured at MSP. So we are not talking on the real issues which need to be addressed if we really want to address the concerns of the farmers. Loan waiver is absolutely one part of it. We support a one-time loan waiver, but if we do not follow it up with real institutional measures, the loan waiver will be nothing like the previous loan waiver some years ago, which did not yield anything in the long run. And we are back to square one with farming again being unprofitable, farmers again in distress. So this cycle will go on repeating. Yes. Parties will make promises. News will come out of paltry sums being given in the name of loan waivers. And if there are no institutional measures to really address the issue, we'll be back to square one time.
Gurishik, go ahead. And my question remains the same. Gurishik, how is the BJP and the Congress different in Madhya Pradesh? If you can explain to me, I would be very grateful.
There is no comparison between Congress and BJP. It was BJP who brought the interest rate for farmers from 18 and 16% to 0%. It was BJP who had introduced the Kisan credit card. We had done the 100% electrification of the villages. We had increased the area of a cultivated land. And what these people have done, they have just given fake promises. You look at my Congress's counterpart, he is not telling anything that how will they get the money. He's just keep on saying that his chief minister is a wizard and he will definitely invent some money. But this is not the way things go. And what he was saying that since the monetary condition of the state was not good, so they were knowing before the elections itself what are the liabilities and assets of the state. So why they put the promises which they can't fulfill? So just right now what they are trying to say, they just want to buy time so that the code of moral conduct for Lok Sabha election is imposed, and they will say that we will waiver the loans of the farmers after that. If there was any intention of wavering of loans, they would have done it in the same way in which we had wavered of all the dues of electricity, which was for the BPL people.
So tell me something, Gurishik, the list of things that you've given me, you've reduced, you said, the loan interest for farmers to 0%. You've given them credit cards, you've given them electricity, you've given them rural development, you've given them all of these wonderful things. Then how is it that the number of suicides in Madhya Pradesh under the watch of the BJP went up so sharply? And in 2017, in Mandsaur, the farmers actually went on a rampage and the police had to shoot at them, which you claim, your government claimed, was completely warranted and it was nobody's fault. So if you're telling me that the BJP gave everything to the farmers, first of all, why did they vote you out of power? Secondly, why were they upset? Why were they committing suicide? What neither of these parties have been able to answer is why you don't have proper sound policies for the farmers. And you keep making these promises that you have no intention to keep. And as a result, the farmers are dying. A quick question to Sudhir Tiwari. Mr. Tiwari, आप हमें ये बताइए कि ये जो ऋण माफी है इन्होंने अनाउंस किया था 17 दिसंबर को.
Let me answer.
उसके बाद 17 दिसंबर के बाद चार हमारे पास जो जानकारी है, चार किसानों ने आत्महत्या की है मध्य प्रदेश में. आपके पास आपकी जानकारी, आप हमें बताइए कि अभी हाल क्या है किसानों का.
जी, चार किसानों ने अभी पिछले एक महीने में आत्महत्या करी है. और केवल जो इशू यही रहा है कि वो समझ रहे थे कि हमारा 2 लाख रुपए, जैसा कि टीवी और चैनलों के माध्यम से कि हमारा 2 लाख रुपए माफ हो जाएगा, ये समझ के. बट वो जब अपने घर पे जाते हैं और जब हमेशा उनके पास फोन पे फोन बैंक अधिकारियों के आते हैं कि आप अपना लोन चुकाइए, और हमें ऐसी कोई नॉलेज नहीं है, हमारे पास कोई ऐसा आदेश नहीं आया है कि आपका लोन माफ हुआ है. ऐसे जो किसान अभी जिन्होंने आत्महत्या करी है, किसी का हार्ट अटैक हुआ है, ये सिर्फ एक लोन एक कारण है. मेरा मतलब ये है, मेरा ये सिर्फ कहना है कि फेक कमिटमेंट, गलत कमिटमेंट से आत्महत्या सुसाइड रेट और बढ़ेगा. क्योंकि हम लोग जो हैं एक अनऑर्गेनाइज कम्युनिटी, जो ऐसी कम्युनिटी जो कि इन बातों को नहीं समझती, आपकी पॉलिसी को नहीं समझती. उन्होंने अप टू आपने 2 लाख रुपए बोला है, वो 2 लाख समझ रहे हैं. उन्हें ये नहीं मालूम कि ये सेल की तरह आप अप टू बोल रहे हो, कि अप टू मतलब उसमें कम भी है और ज्यादा है. किसी का अगर 2 लाख रुपए तो उन्होंने ये सोच रखा है कि उनका 2 लाख रुपए माफ होगा. साथ साथ किसान की हालत के लिए सुधारने के लिए कोई राजनीतिक इच्छा शक्ति केंद्र में बीजेपी सरकार ने जब चुनाव आने के पहले बोलते हैं कि हम स्वामीनाथन रिकमेंडेशन फॉलो कर मानेंगे, उनकी उनकी रिपोर्ट को लागू करेंगे, चुनाव होता है, जीतते हैं, सुप्रीम कोर्ट में देते हैं एफिडेविट कि हम उसको मान नहीं सकते हैं. अभी जैसे लोन वेवर की बात हुई, इसमें उन्होंने पेचीदगियां लगा रखी हैं. किसानों का भला कौन करेगा, उसकी राजनीतिक इच्छा शक्ति किसके पास है, ये बड़ा हमारे लिए बड़ा ही एक वो इशू रहता है. साथ साथ मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि लोन, एक तो लोन एक किसान की अगर आपको उसकी स्थिति सुधारना है तो एक लोन वेवर इज अ वन ऑप्शन. सेकंड ऑप्शन है इसको पूरा दाम. अगर उसको किसी भी व्यापारी को अगर उसका पूरा दाम नहीं मिलेगा तो वो कैसे उसको सर्वाइव करेगा. अगेन वो फिर लोन में आएगा, उसका अगेन वो सुसाइड करेगा, ये चक्र चलता जाएगा. उसके लिए आपको एक सॉलिड पॉलिसी नीति आयोग जो है बनाने, जो हमारे यहाँ नीति आयोग बनाता है, तो पूरे देश के लिए पॉलिसी बनाता है, उसको ये सोचना चाहिए कि उसमें फॉर्म्स
मतलब
किसान हो नीति आयोग में बनाने, आप जिनके लिए आप बना रहे हो, जिसमें आप पॉलिसी जिनके लिए बना रहे हो उसमें कोई फॉर्मर नहीं है. साथ साथ आप कोई भी आपका ऐसा कोई भी चीज को कमिटमेंट करते नहीं हो. आपको कोई डिले करना होता है तो आप आयोग पे आयोग बनाते हो. इधर आप लोन वेव कर रहे हो तो आपने 3 टाइप की कैटेगरी कर दी कि हम यहाँ करेंगे.
एक मिनट, आकाश जिंदल से भी पूछना है. सॉरी आकाश जिंदल, ऑब्वियसली योर क्वेश्चंस विल नॉट बी आंसर्ड.
कम इन फॉर 10 सेकंड्स.
यस, गो अहेड आकाश जिंदल.
Yeah, I want to ask my Congress friend, the main issue which I have been stressing right from the start is to get good price, the right price for the produce of our agriculturist brother. That's the best way to help our agriculturist brother apart from other things. Now, there was a scheme called Bhavantar Bhuktan Yojana.
Yes.
Under which what was happening was the difference between the MSP and the realizable price was being compensated up to some extent. Now, I want to know from my Congress friend, are you going to continue that scheme? And if you are going to continue that scheme along with the loan waiver, now for that scheme also, where would you raise the funds for? And what are your comments on that scheme? Because up to a certain extent, that scheme was getting the agriculturist up to some amount. It was plugging the difference between the price realized and the MSP. So that can be one effort to get him the good produce, the good yes. price for his produce.
Yes, it's a very valid suggestion. And of course, while we've come to the end of this discussion, I will remind the representative of the Congress that we're going to keep a very, very close eye on this entire thing. And we'll be carrying regular updates so that the whole country knows what's happening in Madhya Pradesh. And it's not just left to the poor farmers who have to fend for themselves, because the whole country is going to be voting in 3 months. And these are stories that you should know before you make that choice. At the end of the day, our farmers are in desperate need for help. Political parties will always take advantage of that desperation and make promises that they may not be able to keep. We're going to keep a close eye on Madhya Pradesh to see if the Madhya Pradesh government keeps its promise. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.